Welcome to Data Millennials. I'm Atul, and in this video, we are going to discuss about the MID function in Excel. So this MID function is categorized under Excel text functions, and this function will return a specific number of characters from the middle of a given text. So you might think that where this MID function will be useful to you. While doing your analysis, this MID function can be very useful if you wish to extract characters from the middle of a given specific text. So, for example, in this video, we will try to get the state name from the customer address. And this state name is somewhere in the middle of this delivery address. So, in row 6, for this customer, the state that we want to extract in our result set is Delhi, right? And this Delhi is in between this NCR India from the right side, and from the left side it's in lane 5 south, lane 5, right? So how we can get this Delhi part, which is a state, in the address? Now the thing is that for the first row you can see that this is Delhi and NCR, right? So you can consider either Delhi as a state or NCR as a state, while NCR is not a state but Delhi is, right? Well, in row number 7 you can see that the state name is between the country name and after the city name. So for most of the example you can see that there is a city name and then the state name. So this will put our example in a pattern, is that there is a lane name, then there is a lane specific address, and then there is a city, and then the state, and then country. So now we can see that there is a pattern that the state name starts after 3 commas, right? And we have to get the state name from the middle of the entire delivery address. To get the number of characters from the middle of a given text string, we use this MID function. To use this MID function, we'll simply use equal to, and then we'll put MID. The first argument that MID is asking is the text. So this is the required argument, and it is the original text string from where you want to get the part or the substring. So for us, the text will be this cell A6 in which the delivery address is there. Now it's asking me for the start number. Now if I count the start number, right, it will be very difficult for me. There might be 100, the state can start from 100th location, or it can start at the 115th location, right? So right now let's assume that our state starts at 15th location. Okay, so I'll put 15, and then it is asking me the number of characters that you want to extract from the middle of that specific text. And suppose I want only 4 characters, right? So what is happening here is that this MID function goes to this cell C6, okay, and then from 15th character till 19th character it will take out the extract, it will take out the characters. So if we count here, so the L is on the first character, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15th. So at 15th location, or A is at the 15th, A is the 15th character, right? And from 15th, we want 4. So A will be at 15th, 15 plus 4 will be 19, which is 15, 16, 17, 18, right? Till 18th character, it will get the substring, because in your formula you have given 4. So if you see that number of characters that you want, 4 characters. So now, as per the example, we have to get the state name, right? And the state name starts after the three commas. So first of all, we have to find the three comma, where this three comma basically ends. And then we have to get the number of characters for that state. Reason being is that you will see in the first row, there is NCR, which is of three character. Okay. Then we have Maharashtra, which is more than three character. Then we have Karnataka, which is of different character, right? So the state name can have 5 character, 10 character, 20 character, you don't know. So we have to put the number of character, the third argument in the mid function dynamically, so that our entire state name can be extracted, right? So the first thing that we have to do is that we have to find the position at which the third comma is there. Okay, so we'll simply use the find function, which we have used in our previous videos also. So we'll put find, okay, and we'll find comma. Within this text, and we'll put the first one, the first starting position is at 1. Okay, now within this find function, again we will use the find function, but now we have to find the comma from 7th position onward. So what we'll do is that we'll simply use again the find function here. Okay, my bad. So we'll put find, okay, and the text will be comma, within text will be this, and the number starting will be this find, the first find which we have used, plus 1, because comma is found at 7th position. So we want to start finding the comma from 8th position of the text. So the second comma appears at 20th position. So this first comma is at 7th position. This second comma is at 20th position. Similarly, we will again use this find, the two find which we have applied as an argument for third find function. Right? So the text which we are searching is comma within this text, and then we will use this 20th position plus 1, which is 21. So now we know that the third comma is at 26th position. So the first argument for our mid function, which is the start number, will be 26 plus 1, because NCR starts at 27th position. Okay, now we have to find out that how many characters are present in the state, and for each row we have different states which might have different characters. So what we'll do is that we have to make this third argument, which is the number of characters, also dynamic. So how we can do that? We know in our delivery addresses the pattern is that after a state we give country name. So if we look from right side to left side, if we take this part and then we have already removed this part, right? And if we take out this part, then we will left out with only the state. So from right side, if we find out the first comma position, then we will be able to get the state name correctly, right? So what we will do is that we will start finding comma from the right side, right? So we'll put find, and we are searching for comma within this text. Okay, we are searching for within this text, right? And the start number should be this 26 plus 1, because we have already known that till 26, at 26th position there is a third comma, and we need to find out the fourth comma. So this 26 plus 1. Okay, now we know that at 26th till 26th position here we have our lane and city name. At 30th position we have our state name. Till 29th position we have our state name, and at 30th position we have a comma which segregate the state with the country name, right? So if we get the difference between this 30 minus this, right, which is 4, so it gives us 4, right? And we have to find out the state name. But if you see the pattern here, we have a state name which has character length of 3, and if we minus 1 here, if we basically simply put 4 minus 1, then ideally we should have the which is 3, yeah. So ideally we should have the NCR in our address, right? So if I put equal to mid, right, and the text is this one, the start number will be this 26 plus 1, okay, and the number of character will be this 3, right, then we can get our state name correctly. Let's get this entire thing, let's get this formula dragged for this entire data set. Okay, so for our second row we know that the state name appears at 35th position, because till 34 we have this city name and lane name. At 45th position there is a comma which segregate the state name from the country name, so we have to get 10 characters. So this Maharashtra has 10 characters, so if we drag this formula here we will get our state name correctly, right? Now we have used a different bunch of formulas here in order to make our mid arguments dynamic, right? And you can see that you have used different cells here. What in case we want to use this find function within this mid function? So basically I'll simply copy this entire formula. Okay, so this was the first argument, right? So we had used an f6 plus 1, right? So if I put mid, then this is the c6 text where we want to get, or where we want to extract the data from, where we want to extract the data, and then the start number. So in the start number I'll use this formula which is in cell f6 to find out the third comma. From the third comma position, if I add 1, then we'll get the starting of the state name. Then the last part which is it's asking is the number of characters, right? So the number of characters here is 3, right? So instead of 3 which we are getting here, if we use this formula where we had found out the fourth comma and then we basically minus it with the length of this one, the third comma, then we can get the exact state name, right? So we'll copy this formula here, basically we'll put it in another cell, and then we will copy this formula also, okay, and we will minus it with the previous one. So we'll simply put this minus this, and with this formula we'll minus 1, because we need to get the exact state name, right? So if I copy this entire formula and if I put it here as the last position, we should get NCR as the result. There you go, you have this NCR. So right now you can see that if I even remove these things, right, if I remove these formulas which I have applied here, okay, there is somewhere I'm using this 26 with f6 plus 1, so instead of f6 I have to give this entire formula. Now we are not using anything from this side, right? So this is a huge formula. In order to make our arguments dynamic, we have used this find function multiple times. So now if I drag this formula now down, I'm getting my state name in a proper order. So basically this mid function is useful if you wish to extract the characters from the middle of the specific text, and it requires three arguments: the text, from where do you want to extract the substring, the start number, from which position do you want to start extracting, and the number of character till which point you want to extract that substring. So that's how basically you use this find function. Hey, if you find this video insightful, then do check out other videos and hit the like and subscribe button.